There's no one e-commerce store that has all the right features in the right combination to make the perfect online store. Each store has its strengths and each store has its weaknesses. If you want to sell online successfully, you need to understand each of these platforms, their strengths and their weaknesses, and place them side by side to see how they work in comparison to one another. This way you can pick out the platform that works best for you. And that's what we're going to be doing in today's video. We'll be comparing and contrasting two juggernauts in the e-commerce space, Amazon and Walmart. We already did a comparison of Amazon and Shopify before, so if you missed that, we'll leave the link in the description down below so you can check it out. And now without further ado, let's get straight into the video. So for today's video, we'll be comparing these two platforms based on four different categories. But before then, let's give a brief overview of both platforms. In the world of e-commerce, Amazon is king, accounting for almost 40% of all e-commerce sales today. Even when the pandemic hit and its supply chain was affected, Amazon still witnessed a 25% boost in sales. But still, Amazon has had its fair share of lows. In the same pandemic where they witnessed a 25% increase in sales, they almost lost a total of $1.3 billion in operating profit. Nevertheless, Amazon soldiers on, dealing death blows to brick and mortar stores at its goals. The future is not ours to tell, but from what it looks like standing here, Amazon is going to remain at disadvantage for a long time to come. For the first time ever in 2020, another company threatened to surpass eBay as the second largest e-commerce platform in the US, and that company was Walmart. In 2020, when Amazon was facing delays fulfilling its Prime orders, orders at Walmart marketplace skyrocketed, speaking in part to Walmart's established reputation as the king of brick and mortar retail stores. Plus, since Walmart purchased Jet.com in 2016, Walmart's sales have almost tripled. It's still not close to the sales volume of Amazon, but it sure is impressive. So now let's compare. On Amazon, a professional selling plan goes for a monthly subscription of $39.99. There is no listing fee, but Amazon does collect a referral fee for each sale, and this fee is usually 8% of the sale. But there are also certain categories that attract as much as 15% or even 20% referral fee. You can decide to join the Fulfillment by Amazon program, that is the Amazon FBA, and this is how most people sell on Amazon. If you join this program, Amazon will be processing and fulfilling your orders for you for a small fee. They will also help store your inventory at their facilities, also for a fee, and help you with things like returns and customer service. The Amazon FBA is a godsend since it lets business owners focus on other aspects of their business while Amazon handles the day-to-day, like packaging the order, delivering them to customers, and handling customer support, as we mentioned. But beware, because fees for these services can quickly add up. On Walmart, on the other hand, there are no listing fees or monthly subscription fees, but there are referral fees, just between 18 to 15%, just like Amazon. Also, Walmart has its own fulfillment program called Walmart Fulfillment Services, a rival to the Amazon's FBA program. It is similar to the Amazon FBA, however, it is not open to many sellers the way Amazon FBA is. Only people who are already sellers on Walmart Marketplace can become WF sellers, and if you're a new seller and want to join the program, it's very unlikely that you'll be approved right now. Besides that, your products must have a UPC, except for a few product categories that are exempted, and these UPCs cost a whole lot to get. With Amazon, it's super easy and straightforward to onboard and list your products. Simply subscribe to a selling plan, create your Seller Central account, and then you can create your listing either manually through the Seller Central, or you can upload your listings in bulk through Amazon's inventory file templates. The main challenge with listing on Amazon is that Amazon's criteria is always changing, and oftentimes with little to no notice to the sellers. Even experienced sellers often make listing errors, and if your listing has too many errors, you won't be able to make sales. But generally, you can say listing on Amazon is quite easy. Walmart, on the other hand, makes the process of onboarding quite steep. You have to first send in an application, do a trust and safety review, demonstrate that you have marketplace experience, and present some other qualifications if demanded. Then Walmart has to review all of this and decide if you're fit for the platform, and the process usually takes a while. When you do get approved, Walmart will then send you a list of instructions on how to create your new listing. You can do that manually through Excel Upload, through API, or through a software partner. But Walmart's API is still quite rudimentary and it's not easy to work with. In the end, it might be better to use a software partner or try Shopify's Walmart integration instead. Then there's the UPC requirement, which gives sellers a lot of headache. Trust me, you can request exemption, but it's still a rigorous process to request that exemption. So keep that in mind. Through Amazon Prime, Amazon has changed the face of shipping and fulfillment in e-commerce. In fact, the brand has effectively modified customer expectations when it comes to delivery. With Prime, members enjoy free shipping on next day and 2-day deliveries. And so in order to gain access to Prime, most Amazon sellers sell through FBA. However, this can be quite risky, as we saw in March 2020 when Amazon temporarily removed non-essentials from their FBA program. So a better approach for selling on Amazon right now is a hybrid approach where you keep part of your inventory either in your own warehouse or in a 3PL. If you use a tech-supported 3PL, you can even achieve 2-day delivery as well. But be that as it may, Amazon is working aggressively on its logistics still. The brand plans to add 81 aircraft to its fleet, as well as 100,000 electric delivery vans. So we can expect that shipping and fulfillment are only going to get more efficient going forward for Amazon. Walmart has its own version of Prime called Walmart Plus. Through the program, customers get free and unlimited same-day shipping on all their grocery items. Walmart Plus also applies to customers who buy in-store. They get to benefit from Walmart's scan-to-go service. But there are other delivery options on Walmart too. There's the 2-day program which sellers can participate in to get the 2-day shipping tag on their listings. This tag boosts your ranking and increases your chances of winning the buy box. To qualify for the 2-day program, a seller must meet a few requirements, and there are 3 ways you can qualify. First, you have to prove yourself by selling on the marketplace for at least 3 months and ensure you keep to Walmart's performance standards in that time. 2, outsource your fulfillment process to Walmart's delivery service. 3, you can go through Walmart's fulfillment services, but this is only available to established sellers on Walmart. But besides the 2-day program, Walmart also has next day delivery and 2-hour delivery service, and these have been making progress, especially since the wake of the pandemic. For now, neither of these options are available for marketplace sellers to leverage, but it's very likely that they will be soon. Amazon is far more established than Walmart, generating about 8 times more sales than Walmart. And so, understandably, it's a cutthroat world out there, and you have to look out for yourself because Amazon is not always straightforward and transparent in their dealings with the sellers. Many experienced sellers and experts advise beginners to come to Amazon with caution while looking for other ways to diversify rather than treat Amazon as a business strategy all on its own. Walmart, on the other hand, still has a long way to go, especially when it comes to technology integration. Besides its less than impressive features, Walmart is also quite difficult to navigate, making even the simplest of tasks tedious to carry out. Most who want to sell on Walmart end up having to work through a third party rather than through Walmart Seller Central, which is quite difficult to use. Still, many sellers seem to feel that doing business is easier on Walmart, especially considering the cost. Fees are lower and competition is lower also. Plus, Walmart isn't exactly resting on its oars. So we can expect to see Walmart gaining more momentum as it continues to improve on its game. So we've laid out the cards, but it's up to you. Which of these platforms do you think appeals to you the most? Do let us know in the comment section down below. And don't forget to like this video, subscribe to the channel, and hit the notification bell so you know once we drop new content. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you guys at the top.